to Isaiah 64:8. Yet, O Lord, thou art our God and Father. We are the clay, and thou art the potter. We are the work of thy hand. Be not exceedingly angry, O Lord, and remember not iniquity forever. Behold, consider we all thy people. Thy holy cities have become a wilderness. Zion has become a wilderness. Jerusalem a desolation. Our holy and most beautiful house, where our fathers praised thee, has been burnt by fire, and our pleasant places have become ruins. Will thou restrain thyself at those things, O Lord? Wilt thou keep silent and affect us sorely? So now the people are getting concerned, and they're praying out to God. And even Job, in his hardships, he cried out in 10 verse 9, Remember that thou hast made me of clay, and will not turn me to dust again. See, when God had created, he will turn to dust. So in our scripture today, Jeremiah had been to the potter's house. He had seen the potter making a vessel, and he knew that it was love behind the potter's pressures, that when the vessel was marred, the potter was capable of crushing it down again and bringing it to nothing but a lump, and then molding it and shaping it once again, perhaps doing this time and time again, until at last it fulfilled what God wanted. And that is the great lesson Jeremiah learned at the potter's house, that we can learn ourselves. And in Paul, the second letter to Timothy, he says, that was Paul, second letter to Timothy, verses 2:20. In a great house there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of wood and earthly ware, and some for noble use or for honor, and some for dishonor. If anyone purifies himself from what is dishonorable, and that's those wrongful attitudes, contentiousness, ungodliness, doctrinal abrasions, iniquity, then he will become a vessel for noble use, consecrated and useful to the master of the house, ready for any good work. Oh, I know this can be a very deep subject, and there's so much to it, and I could go in different directions, but I'm going to try to summarize it for you by saying, God created all mankind, the good, the evil, and we, the offsprings of Adam and Eve, put ourselves into situations where we mess up. But God, who is faithful and just, he will help straighten it out and straighten the circumstances around us. By making the things that were messed up, he will bring them to perfection once again, and he will get the glory for doing so. I believe that before the master builder, the patient potter, and the healer of all things is finished with any given thing that he created, it will all be perfect. He will proudly say, Look at what I, the Lord, has done. 2 Chronicles 7:14 tells us in one verse what the message of the potter is saying. That's 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and forgive them their sin and will heal their land. Amen. God does not forget his people. He did not forget the Israelites when they didn't do the things that he told them to do. And he will not forget me and you when we sin. You see, even though his people were captive in Babylonian, he planned to give them a new beginning and a new purpose to turn them into the new people. In times of deep trouble, he may be preparing you and I, as he did the people of Judah, for a new beginning with him at the center. God, as the great potter and the sovereign God, has a right to create or remake any man or woman. We must let him have his way in our lives. The clay does not have to struggle. God wants us to rest in his hands. So remember, earlier we saw in Jeremiah chapter 18, he was using his clay and molded it by his hands. But something went wrong, so he used that clay to make another pot the way he wanted it. Note, he didn't throw it away. He made use that same clay to make another pot. The art of making a pot has not changed through the centuries. The wheel is now turned by an electric motor, but that is about the only difference. Even this is still controlled by the foot of the potter. It's like a sewing machine and your little foot on the throttle. And he used that to make the wheel turn and to control its speed. Today, the ingredients of the potter, the clay, and the wheel are still part of making a pot. The potter is still the same in his capable hands, guided by his intelligence, working to mold and shape the clay to the vessel he has in mind. The clay is the same clay it's always been. The wheel stands for the circumstances, however, in our lives, under the control of the potter, or God. So by taking a lump of ugly clay, the potter shapes and forms into a lovely work of art. And at some point, it may fall, and often does. But he takes it up again in his loving hands and starts the process all over again. This is me and you. We are the pots or the vessels in God's hands. Something goes wrong and we fall and we sin, but God is faithful to pick up the pieces and start again. Christ, he is the kind of leader that will never leave us nor forsake us. He will always be with us. That's in my favorite scriptures of Deuteronomy 31:6 and Hebrews 13:5. And he will carry us when we cannot walk. That reminds me of the footprints in the sand. You remember you saw two sets of footprints, and all of a sudden they merged to one. And the person said, "What happened to the other set, Lord? I thought you was walking with me." But no, what happened was the Lord picked you up and like put you on his shoulders and carried you through. When we were down, it would be him that would reach down with his loving hands and pick us up, dust off our clothes, and like a little child, the mama will put peroxide over our scrapes and kiss it and make it better and send us back to try again. If some hard circumstances comes into your life, or for some it may be there right now, or it may be just around the corner, or you may have just gone through it, that circumstance is the wheel of God to bring you against the pressures of the potter's hand. If you do not resist, if your will does not spoil the work by complaining, grumbling, feeling resentment, or being bitter, then you will accept the workings of the potter, and the pressure will be eased, and the vessel will take shape. But if there's resistance, if that human will, like some imperfection in that clay, chooses something other than what the potter has in mind, then the potter can do nothing but crush it back down again to a lump and begin with that same lump and make it over to a vessel that suits his heart and mind. The great lesson Jeremiah learned at the potter's house was that the sovereign control of God, he is the potter and we are the clay. He knows the future, and his plans for us are good and full of hope. This does not mean that we'll be spared any pain or any suffering or hardship. God never promised us that. As a matter of fact, he tells us that there will be trials and tribulations in our life. He tells us that we are not of this world, but that we are separate from this world. He tells us that the world will hate us because of him. So the more you develop a Christ-like character, the more you will bring glory to God. The Bible says, as the Spirit of the Lord works within us, we become more and more like him and reflect his glory. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against there are no law. This can be found in Galatians 5:22-23. As we seek to be kind to one another and love others with the love of God, we will become patient, long-suffering, gentle, and loving, as the Lord made us, because he is the potter and we are the clay. In his hands, when we surrender to his will, Jesus will mold and make us into his image as we yield to the Spirit of the Lord. Christian character is what makes us reflect the Lord's glory as we allow the Lord's Spirit to mold and bring us into his image. We will find that we become more and more like Jesus. The old saying, Jesus first, others second, and self last, is more than just a motto, and it should be the way of life to have true joy.